Believe it or not, solar panels aren't exactly pros at handling the sun. Sounds backwards, right? But it's true. Excess heat can be a big problem for solar panels. It drags down their efficiency and can even shorten their lifespan. So how do you keep something that's basking in the sun all day from overheating? One clever solution: combine solar panels with a heat pump. The heat pump swoops in, grabs the excess heat from the panels, and repurposes it to warm your home or water. This dynamic duo keeps the panels cooler, helps the heat pump work more efficiently, and saves you money. They're the Batman and Robin of renewable energy. But if this combo is such a great idea, why haven't we been doing it all along? And do the potential energy savings really make up for the hefty upfront costs? I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. This video is brought to you by Incogni. So what's the big idea? Well, it's called a solar assisted heat pump, or SAHP. I'm just gonna call it SAP for short. It's easier to say. German company PaXos Solar thinks its sleek, stylish solar roof SAP in particular could revolutionize residential solar and heat pump systems. This is PaXos's new SAP, a two-in-one system that combines heating and solar power generation. Instead of mounting traditional solar panels on your roof, it uses PV tiles that become your roof, much like Tesla's solar roof. It's perfect for anyone who loves the idea of solar energy but isn't thrilled about the aesthetics of standard panels. But don't let this sleek design fool you. These tiles are more than just eye candy. They're installed over a water-bearing layer with enough space underneath for airflow. And that's where the magic happens. Solar panels are great at absorbing light, but sunlight doesn't just bring light, it also brings heat. If you ever baked in a kitchen flooded with summer sun, I hope you treated yourself to some lemonade while doing it, you know how intense that can be. As I mentioned before, too much heat actually hurts solar panels' performance. For instance, if a panel has a temperature coefficient of -0.5%, that means for every 1 degree Celsius increase in temperature, a solar panel's efficiency can drop by about 0.5%. The specifics vary panel to panel. And cooling solar panels while they're hard at work can dramatically improve their performance. And when it comes to cooling, water is hard to beat. Ask anyone who has a water-cooled PC. They'll probably back me up. Heat pumps, on the other hand, face a whole different challenge. If you've been here before, you know that I'm a heat pump enthusiast. And if you own one, you probably are too. These systems can achieve a coefficient of performance, or COP, greater than 1, meaning they output more heat energy than the electricity that they consume. Some even have a COP of 3 or higher. That's 3 units of heat for every unit of electricity that you put in. That's something no traditional space heater can match because physics. So how do they pull off this magic trick? Well, heat pumps don't create heat, they move it. They capture warmth from outside air and transfer into your home, keeping you cozy without guzzling energy. But, and there's always a but, when temperatures drop, heat pumps have to work harder. The colder it gets, the lower their COP. In extreme conditions, some models rely on backup heaters, which can eat into your energy savings. But again, you're never gonna really get below COP of 1. Air source heat pumps are particularly prone to this. In colder climates, they often include heating elements to defrost their heat exchangers, which is handy, but it's an energy hog that takes a bite out of the energy and cost savings. But before you start typing frantically into the comments, there are more and more cold climate heat pumps hitting the market, making this better and better. And to summarize, heat pumps need extra warmth sometimes, while solar panels often need to cool down. The symbiotic relationship between them is what makes PaXos a potential solution to both problems. By tackling the downsides of both solar panels and heat pumps, this system combines the best of both worlds. It's a smart, elegant solution that boosts efficiency and reduces energy waste. So here's how it works. Warm air from under the tiles is piped into the heat pump's heat exchanger, and when the air is at least 1 Kelvin warmer than ambient, a fan switches on, cooling the tiles while warming the heat pump. This keeps the heat pump efficient in winter. In summer, the tiles generate enough energy to power the pump, keeping your home comfortable year-round. PaXos says this setup cuts the heat pump's energy use by 20% annually compared to a similar device without the additional heat generation, a claim that's been tested by the Technical University of Cologne. A preliminary study concluded that this boosted the heat pump's coefficient of performance by nearly 25%, weather permitting. That's a lot from a device that doesn't look very flashy by design. The tiles are sleek, made to look like regular roofing to appeal to those who dislike traditional panels. They use LONGi's back contact cells, which capture angled light for extra efficiency. Larger tiles, which are 59.5 centimeters by 42.2 centimeters, also make installation faster as fewer tiles cover the same area. Just 5 tiles over 10 square feet can generate 1 kilowatt peak of power. That's worth about 1,400 euros or about $1,487. With all these advantages, why aren't SAPs everywhere yet? Before I get into that, I need to talk to you about another piece of technology that can help protect your privacy. which is a big problem. Have you ever been deluged by random promotional emails from random companies that you've never heard of? Well, today's sponsor, Incogni, can help get to the source of that problem and restore some of your privacy. As my wife and I were getting our house constructed, setting up loans, getting insurance, and everything else that you have to do with moving, I saw a major uptick in the amount of spam and promotional emails that I was getting. I'm sure you've experienced this kind of thing too. That happened because companies sold my information to data brokers, and sometimes they sell your info to some pretty shady people. Incogni can help you with this. We have the right to request that data brokers delete our information, but it takes a lot of time and effort. I signed up for Incogni, gave them the legal right to work on my behalf, and then just sat back and relaxed. You'll see updates in your account for which data brokers they've sent legal requests to and which ones have complied. It really couldn't be easier. If you want to take back some of the control around who has access to your personal information, give Incogni a try. Take your personal data back with Incogni. Use code UNDECIDED at the link below and get 60% off an annual plan. Thanks to Incogni and to all of you for supporting the channel. So back to the question, why aren't SAHPs everywhere yet? Let's explore where they came from. The concept of combining solar energy with heat pumps isn't new. In 1955, researchers E.R. Ambrose and Philip Sporn explored using solar collectors to boost a heat pump's efficiency. However, the first recognizable solar-assisted heat pump came from NASA in 1973 in the form of a solar-powered absorption cycle heat pump. NASA made the design available to private industry just as the energy crisis ramped up interest in alternatives to fossil fuels. Now, SAHPs gained traction because heating and cooling are massive energy hogs. In 2022, they accounted for 45% of residential energy use, with water heating adding another 12.9%, according to the University of Michigan. That's a lot of potential savings, and SAHPs can handle water heating too, but that's a topic for another day. For commercial buildings, the stakes are even higher. In 2018, US commercial buildings spent $140 billion on energy, with space heating taking up nearly a third of that. Cutting those costs with clean energy isn't just good for the planet, it's great for the budget too. Interest in SAHPs faded after the oil crisis ended, but incremental improvements kept coming through the 70s, 80s, and beyond. So with decades of progress, we must all be enjoying cutting-edge SAHPs on all of our homes right now, right? Right? Obviously, not exactly. So why doesn't every house in your neighborhood have a SAHP? Well, the answer lies in their shared weaknesses and the cost. Like heat pumps, SAHPs struggle in cold weather, and cold weather is often cloudy, meaning the solar panels can't provide as much help when the heat pump needs it most. Another hurdle is integrating solar and heat pump components. This requires what one paper calls precise calibration, or the balancing of changing air temperatures, sunlight levels, and the building's heating or cooling needs. It's a complex juggling act, especially in real time. Some research suggests this complexity might even be a drawback. A 2021 study by the University of Hull and North China Electrical Power University found that combining solar thermal panels with heat pumps can lead to constant operation, increasing electrical use and inefficiency. Cost, however, is the biggest barrier. Solar roofs are notoriously expensive as they replace your actual roof, and heat pumps aren't exactly super cheap either. Now combine the two, and it's no surprise the price adds up. According to EcoSmart, a US-based green construction company, a SAHP system costs between $2,000 and $6,000 depending on the model and manufacturer. Over in the UK, Home Building and Renovating magazine estimates material costs at up to £2,000 or about $2,540. Installation adds even more. SAHPs are specialized, the technology is still relatively new, and there aren't many trained installers yet, all of which drive up the cost further. So how does a SAHP like PaXos' system stack up against a solar tile technology like Tesla Solar Roof? Well, let's break it down, but first, a few caveats. This comparison is a little bit of apples to oranges. Tesla Solar Roof doesn't include a heat pump, which is a major part of PaXos' appeal. Unfortunately, we still don't have solid data yet on what the extra functionality means in dollars and cents. Even if we did, solar pricing depends on countless variables, like where you live, your roof size, and local labor costs. So take this analysis with a grain of salt, because some of the PaXos numbers I think are from like European markets, which is very different from the US. But I am using some real-world data from resources like Energysage and roofcalc.com for Tesla Solar Roof. For PaXos, we only have the company-provided numbers, which could tilt things in its favor. When and if real-world data for PaXos becomes available, we'll revisit this comparison. Because rooftops vary, cost per square meter is a fair starting point. Now, according to Energysage, Tesla Solar Roof starts at about $3.90 per watt, which means it averages about $461.50 per square meter. PaXos claims 260 euros or $271 per square meter, giving it a clear edge in affordability. Tesla's solar roof has improved to 165 watts per square meter, up from 118 in earlier versions. For PaXos, things are a little murkier.
Its claimed output is around 189 watts per square meter, but when calculated based on the tile dimensions from the spec sheet, which is 59.5 centimeters by 42.2 centimeters, we get 175.3 watts per square meter.
And this discrepancy may be due to overlaps, as noted by PV Magazine, but it's a little confusing. As I mentioned, Tesla's solar roof starts around $3.90 per watt, while PaXos reports 1.4 euros per watt, or $1.47 at current exchange rates. And that gives PaXos a significant advantage in cost efficiency, but that could just be regional costs at play to explain the difference. So numbers don't tell the whole story. There are important factors to consider here that don't neatly fit on a spreadsheet. As you can see in my video where I teamed up with Paul Barron to compare our experiences between traditional solar and a Tesla solar roof, Tesla has faced challenges like installer shortages that have delayed installations. However, the company has built a reputation for offering turnkey solar solutions. In other words, handling everything from design to activation, which is a big plus, even if customer service post-installation gets mixed reviews. Now, PaXos, meanwhile, faces uncertainty. The company sold its solar tile rights to Swiss manufacturer Meyer Burger, which is now handling production and distribution. However, Meyer Burger recently lost a major US contract, causing its stock to drop by 72% and raising questions about its future and, by extension, PaXos. So which is better? Well, it's complicated. Solar is a deeply personal choice influenced by factors like location, budget, and roof size. And for now, PaXos holds promise on paper, but lacks Tesla's established infrastructure and brand reputation, however you feel about that. The true test will come when PaXos installs 200 systems in Germany next year. Will its system deliver the efficiency and savings that it claims? Can it avoid Tesla's installer bottlenecks? And how many people are willing to replace their entire roof to avoid the look of traditional panels? Germany's 12.3% solar adoption rate dwarfs the US's at 3.4%, so aesthetics may not be a major barrier there. Historically, countries like Germany, Japan, and Nordic nations have embraced solar and heat pumps individually. Combining them could be the next logical step. So where does that leave us when it comes to this technology's maturity? What kind of technology readiness level, or TRL, are SAHPs currently at? Well, answering that question is a little tricky. SAHPs have been quietly working away in some parts of the world for half a century. They're on the market, and you can likely go buy one right now. Per researcher Christian Dick of Köln, PaXos' system is ready for continuous use under real conditions. That certainly sounds like a 7 or higher on the old TRL scale, but at the same time, there's still a lot of room for improvement. The nice thing is that as a fusion of solar panel and heat pump tech, breakthroughs for either of its components can improve a SAHP. Ultimately, SAHPs are a clever piece of technology that help you squeeze every last drop of efficiency out of your system. The downside of having the strengths and weaknesses of both a heat pump and a PV system means there's added complexity. But just because SAHPs aren't great everywhere doesn't mean that we should drop them altogether. For places where the weather and things like costs do support them, combining PVs and heat pumps seems like a great way to kill two birds with one shingle. But what do you think? Would you want a SAHP for your home? Jump in the comments and let me know. And be sure to listen to my follow-up podcast, Still to be Determined, while keep this conversation going. Thanks as always to my patrons for your continued support. Keep your mind open, stay curious, and I'll see you in the next one.